Let's see how to install Microsoft SQL Server on Ubuntu 22.04. We're going to follow the steps here from the Microsoft Learn website, and I leave the link in the video description. So let's start by opening our terminal. I can, of course, install SQL Server on this local computer, but I'm not going to do that, and I'm going to install the SQL Server on a remote server instead. So let's start with connecting to the remote server using SSH. And we need to scroll down until we find this section, Install SQL Server. And here we need to switch tab from Ubuntu 20.04 to Ubuntu 22.04. Before starting the installation itself, let's make sure that our package list is up to date. And we're going to use curl, so let's make sure that it's installed on our server. Now that we're done with that, let's start copying and pasting the commands. We now need to update our package list again. And now we can install SQL Server itself. So the installation is done, and we now need to run the SQL configuration setup. We need to choose the product we want to install. Notice that some products can be used for free, and others are paid. The three free options are Evaluation, Developer, and Express. And among them, only Express can be used in production for free. So feel free to choose whatever you want. I'll go with Express. So I'll choose 3 and enter. We need to accept the license terms. And we now need to provide an administrator password. And let's confirm the password. And the configuration is done. We can verify that the service is running. And we can see that it's active and running. Next, let's install Azure Data Studio to connect to a database using a graphical interface. Notice that I'm going to install Azure Data Studio on the client, that's the local computer, and not the remote server. On the remote server, I only have the database itself, the installation of SQL Server. But Azure Data Studio needs to be installed on the client, which is this local computer in our case. So let's open another tab in the terminal. And this is the terminal of the local computer. Once again, we can use the Microsoft Learn website to help us with the installation. So let's scroll down. And I'm on Linux, so these are the relevant options. And among them, the deb package is probably the simplest one. So let's download it by clicking on the link. And it was downloaded. Let's change to the downloads directory. And if we list the files now, we can see the deb file we just downloaded. Let's use apt to install Azure Data Studio. And Azure Data Studio was installed. If we now open our app drawer, we should be able to find it among the options. Here it is, Azure Data Studio. Let's click on Connections, and let's create a new connection. We need to provide the IP address of the server on which we installed SQL Server. And the default username is SA. The password is the password we chose during the configuration of SQL Server. And let's connect. We need to trust the server certificate. And we're now connected to SQL Server on the remote server. We can expand the databases. And currently we only have the system databases. If, for example, we want to create a new database, we can create a new query. And let's create database. Let's run the query. And if we refresh our databases now, we can see the new database we just created.